Motor Transport Museum in Campo, California began in 1986 with a group of antique truck enthusiasts who were concerned about the continuing loss of historically significant American trucks rusting away or going to the crusher. New zoning laws and vehicle abatement programs, coupled with the problems of finding space to store and display large trucks, put them on the endangered species list. Those individuals quickly recognized it would take an exceptional and ongoing effort to preserve the historic old trucks that are an important link in the chain of events that transformed this nation at the turn of the century. The goal of the Motor Transport Museum is to create one of the 10 best antique truck museums in the country. A complex that will display not only antique trucks, but memorabilia and literature detailing the entire history of the transportation industry and its vital role in making the United States a world leader with the strongest economy and a lifestyle envied by all.
I'd like to welcome you all to the Motor Transport Museum.
The proposed museum would also be a center of learning, an area where volunteers, members, and students can get hands-on experience in the restoration of historic vehicles. Technical skills and knowledge needed to perform that kind of work would be passed on to following generations. Valuable insights that would otherwise be lost forever. The new museum would also have a library, a source of continuing information for restorers, hobbyists, and historians alike. Today's modern interstate haulers and the local trucks that deliver your food, fuel, clothing, just about everything else you use on a daily basis are light years away from the old chain drive open cab models that led us into the 20th century. In 1903, motor trucks underwent their first commercial test in a competition against horse-drawn vehicles in New York City. The new kind of horsepower proved its value and reliability, moving larger amounts of cargo faster and safely. Since then, trucks have steadily evolved into the state-of-the-art machines that today benefit all of mankind in many, many ways. The old Felspar mill that currently houses part of the Motor Transport Museum's restored collection has a colorful history of its own. The East County Mill supplied a goodly amount of the fine white powder that makes everything from spark plugs to dinner plates to porcelain fixtures for bathrooms. The old seven-story building was an active part of San Diego's growing economy during the early part of the 20th century. Automotive pioneer Henry Ford is credited with putting America on wheels with his Model T in the early 1900s, but the wheels of commerce really started turning during World War I, when America and the rest of the world had an urgent need to move tons of goods and people to far-flung corners of the globe. American-made trucks delivered the goods to the front lines, helping Allied nations win World War I, and American-made ambulances brought survivors to field hospitals as quickly as possible. After the war, trucks that proved their durability and usefulness under the toughest of conditions rapidly began replacing the remaining horse-drawn vehicles. They came in all sizes and shapes. Small trucks to deliver milk and ice. Bigger trucks for construction jobs that gave this nation new sources of energy and electric power. In the early 1900s, fewer than 100 miles of were available nationwide. In less than 20 years, a growing highway system stretched for thousands of miles as rural America began to join the 20th century with new conveniences and work-saving equipment brought to them by truck. Electric-powered trucks were common for local deliveries in many big cities. Rolling on solid rubber tires, the transportation industry was beginning to flex its muscles, with new technology leading the way. Mack, White, and Rio are several pioneer truck names that still sound familiar, while Packard, Peerless, Piercero, and Graham were a few of the early truck makers who became better known for building luxury cars. The development of balloon tires in 1926 allowed trucks to double their highway speeds. In the 1930s, diesel engines cut fuel expenses in half, and more trucks were on the road. Construction of the modern federal interstate highways began in the 1950s, and the new diesel-powered haulers brought a new level of prosperity to a nation that developed new industrial strength and a hunger for consumer goods. As you look around the Motor Transport Museum, we'll find trucks and related equipment from all of those eras.
51 could be ordered, having chrome-plated rear-view mirror.
Many of the museum's 150-plus trucks and artifacts are accompanied by interesting historical perspectives and technical details not commonly known. One of the smallest vehicles in the Motor Transport Museum collection is the 1942 Curtiss Jeep, a replica of the famous World War II Jeep. Hollywood movie studios needed Jeeps for war movies they were filming. But the Defense Department wouldn't release Jeeps for civilian uses. The studios turned to Frank Curtiss, a California hot rod veteran and race car builder, who came up with a convincing replica of the military Jeep powered with a four-cylinder Model A Ford motor. The biggest vintage trucks in the museum collection are two old Mack trucks, specially built to haul tons of earth and rock during construction of the Hoover Dam project in the 1930s. And there's Old Smokey, a massive 1954 Diamond T tractor built for the U.S. Navy, designed to handle loads of up to 80 tons. Big and small, short wheelbase, as well as stretched out rigs, the variety of American trucks were and are as diverse as our population. Mass-produced, they still developed identities and personalities of their own. Your interest and support are vital and will allow the museum to continue its operation, fulfill its mission, and meet the ambitious goals for the next 10 years, which include finding additional buildings to house and display a growing collection of American history. The Motor Transport Museum is a California nonprofit operating for charitable and public causes. As a 501c3 chartered organization, donations of vehicles and other forms of economic support are tax deductible. The museum's daily operations are staffed by volunteers who are not paid nor subsidized by any government organizations. Find out how you can be a part of this worthwhile and exciting community effort to preserve the legacy of the American transportation industry. Join the Motor Transport Museum today.